Hello friends, this is Rajiv Sharma. Here I am with you with the video editorial India April 13 on coronavirus related issues. Well, in a few hours from now, the nation will get to know how Prime Minister Modi decides to balance the lives versus livelihood debate when he addresses the nation on April 14 at 10 a.m. We will know how, to what extent he extends the lockdown, with what magnitude, with what exemptions, and with what, to what extent the and which sectors will be opened to kickstart the economy. First of all, if I can give you an indication, a firm indication that the lockdown is going to be extended till 30th of April, that indication has come from the government itself today by an act of government. The central government today extended the visas of all foreigners, all non-Indians presently living in India till 30th of April. And this is, the extension is gratis, that is free of cost, no charges. It's a clear signal that till 30th of April, the extension will continue, lockdown will continue, that is for sure. But equally sure is the fact that this will be a graded response by the Modi government. Modi government is well aware, and Modi himself, being a shrewd politician hailing from Gujarat with acute business sense, he knows what is happening between Japan and China. And as I discussed in my video editorial World April 12 edition, that Japanese government has set aside a special fund of $2.2 billion, or shall I say roughly over 17,000 crore, just to ensure that all Japanese companies currently in China, they evacuate, they shut shop there and resettle either in Japan or elsewhere. Now, this is a whale of an opportunity, which I'm sure Modi government will not be unmindful of. Modi government will be aware of this. We need to harness all those companies, because when the special reallocation fund is worth $2.2 billion, one can imagine that those companies, the what kind of business, the magnitude of business they will be bringing forth, it will run into hundreds of billions of dollars. So this threat of coronavirus can be converted into an opportunity. That is point number one, economically speaking. That is, as I've already said, that there are already indications, firm indications, extension of lockdown will be there, but there will be few exemptions. And now DPIIT, for example, the Department of Promotion of Industry and Internal Trade, has recommended, has come up with a list of 16 sectors which should be exempted. And I'm sure that PM Modi, this time I hope, he will go beyond ghanti and ghanta He will go beyond lighting a candle, lighting a diya, I hope, and he will come to the brass tacks. Now, at a time when the total number of cases has gone up to 9,354 and the total number of deaths has also gone beyond 234 today in India, if you read between the lines, the message is clear that the growth of coronavirus cases still remains very much in control. On expected lines, nothing abnormal about the growth, which is a positive point. Also, another positive point, I mentioned yesterday that around 400 out of 743 districts of India are virus free. They have not reported a single case. So there is no raison d'etre for keeping them under a clampdown. Next point. A happy situation is that the figure given today by the Ministry of Health, Health Ministry, says that 25 districts which had reported coronavirus cases are now virus free. So this is a happy situation. Now I think that considering all this, the Modi government must take a bold decision and keep the lives versus livelihood debate right in forefront. Both are necessary. The last point I would like to make here is, friends, it is very essential that the government of India comes up with a stimulus package, heavy, hefty stimulus package, which should be to the tune of 4 to 5% of the GDP of India, which if you translate into money, it will come into anywhere between $100 billion to $130 billion. And for the uninitiated, $1 billion in today's exchange rates is 7,500 crores. So you can imagine what kind of figures I'm talking about. The very last point here is that the nation will await with bated breath what exact concrete steps PM Modi is going to announce tomorrow to alleviate the sufferings of almost 50 crore Indians who are in the unorganized sector, for whom all hell has broken loose, and they may not be able to, or as it is, as you know that Sonia Gandhi, the Congress leader, has written another letter today to PM Modi, and she has rightly flagged those issues, that hunger has to be kept in the mind, people's hunger, and she has given her own suggestions, which are very valid and good suggestions, saying that that she has welcomed that 10 kilogram of rice per person per month, grains per person per month free should be further extended until September, which is good. But I go beyond that. I would say that it is very important that now all those Jandhan accounts, 33 crore, 330 million, what good they are for? I think time has come when the government puts money in those accounts, and it should be enough. It should not be token amount of 500 rupees or 1000 rupees. It should be enough. With that, I close this video editorial here, and I urge you to put your comments, like, and subscribe to my channel. Thank you.